Why is the DOS path length 260 bytes? Well, to understand the answer to that, you actually have to go way, way back to the early 1980s. This is a time when MS-DOS 2 was being developed, and was developed for machines with 256 kilobytes of memory. The entire operating system was 8 or 10 kilobytes in size. Applications were typically 60K in size. They were limited by that. You couldn't do dynamic allocation, certainly not in the DOS kernel. And when they added hierarchical file system support, they needed a buffer inside the kernel to hold all of the characters in a file name, because they were going to go through and remove dot and dot dot and do all these cleanups on the files names. So they needed a buffer. How do they think about it? Well, 256 bytes seems like a really nice, good long length for a file name. And well, I need to add the drive letter, and I need to write a colon and then a backslash, and can't forget the null at the end of the file name. That's four more characters, 260 bytes. And that's where it comes from. And the thing is, that was what happened back in the early 1980s. And that limit has stuck with us for the following 40 years because it got put into buffers and applications took dependencies on it. And all of a sudden, it becomes really, really, really hard to get rid of limitations like that. Because at the end of the day, the reality is that changing fundamental constructs like that without breaking every application in the world is incredibly hard. And sometimes these really decisions that seem really simple early on can be really nasty and hard to deal with long term.